अस्सलामु अलैकुम डियर ऑल, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल। आई एम मोहम्मद नवीद अंजुम। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन टुडेज ट्यूटोरियल। इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न दैट हाउ टू क्रिएट एंड जॉइन गूगल क्लासरूम एंड क्रिएट क्लासेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ गूगल क्लासरूम ऐप यूजिंग आवर मोबाइल फ़ोन। इन टुडेज ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न दैट हाउ टू शेयर द इनवाइट लिंक विद द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ द क्लास and how to upload the files or documents in your Google Classroom. So let's start our today's video. You will click on Google Classroom app to open the classes, and you can see there are some classes there: 5A girls computer science demo class, 10th C boys and 10th A girls. And in each class you can see there are the number of students. You can see 5A girls have 0 students and demo class have 2 students, 10C boys has 12 students, and so on. So if you want to share the invite link with the students, you are going to click on the 3 dots in front of the class name. First, suppose 5A girls computer science, there are 3 dots present there at the end. You will click on that, and you can see there are options: share invite link and edit. So I want to share the invite link with the students, so you will click on share invite link, and the invite link will be copied. And you can see there are some options to share the link. You will have to you want to share them on the WhatsApp or in the email, it's up to you. So if first suppose I want to share on WhatsApp, I am going to open WhatsApp, and then you're going to search for the name or the, you can see, group for which you have to share the link. So I want to share the link here, so you can see the link have been shared in the IT teachers group. And you can share the link with the students as well on their personal WhatsApp number. So that's all for sharing the link with the students or in the groups. So let's go back to your classes. You want to upload the images, files, documents in the classroom. So for that you have to open your class, and you can see there are 3 options at the bottom: stream, classwork, and people. The streamed work will be shown to students, or the message that you type in the stream will be shown to students at the same time. Okay, and if you want to upload the classwork, you can you will click on classwork and you will click on plus sign. Now you see there are 5 options there: assignment, question, material, reuse, post, and topic. So if you want to give the assignment to the students, you will click on assignments. And if you want to upload the material like your data bank, like your question bank, or something else like images of something for the guidance of students, you will click on material. And if you want to take the test of the students and give the assignment, you will click on assignment. So first suppose I have clicked on assignment. So you on the first box, in the first box you will type the title, and title first suppose I'm typing a title first assignment. First assignment. After that you can type the description. Description is optional. Description is the message that you want to give to the students or class. First suppose complete the assignment. On time. Okay, you can type any message, any number of lines. Okay, it's up to you totally. And after that you can see there are options: points. Points are the marks, that how many marks this assignment have. So first suppose this is the assignment which have 10 marks, 10 points. So you can click on 10, you can write 10 and then click save. After that, due date. This is the option that will be used to give the student the time limit, due date, that for how much time the students can upload the assignment. For suppose I want to give the assignment that student can upload till 30th. So you will write, you will click on due date and you will click on 30th July, and after that 30th July 2021, and you can also give the time. Okay, for the time limit for which the student can upload the assignment on your Google Classroom. So for suppose I'm going to give the time limit till 12 o'clock, or 12 o'clock, then 12 o'clock, you can choose PM or AM according to your need. So I'm going to choose 12 PM. So you can see due Friday 30th July 12 PM. Okay, it means the student can upload the assignment till 12 PM on the date will be 30th July. And after that you can see topic. Topic is used to you can say to make the folder, okay, to make the folder of the material for the class. First, suppose if you want to give the first assignment and there are 3 or 4 test in the first assignment, you can choose the topic, okay. But for now I have only one assignment, so I will not choose the topic. And after that you can see there are 5 girls, all students are there. All students at the top, you can see. If you want to give the assignment to the particular student, you can choose the student by clicking all students. But for now I don't have any student in the class, that's why that option is blurred. And after that you can see you will click on the 3 dots at the top right corner. You can see there are some options: schedule, save draft, delete draft, send Google feedback. If you want to schedule, you can click on schedule. Schedule means that when this assignment will be shown to the students. Okay, schedule. And if you want to save this assignment and you want to schedule this assignment later on, okay, you will click on save draft. And if you want to upload the assignment at the same time in the student's account, you will click on the arrow sign, which is the second option at that top right corner. Okay, second option, you will click on the on this sign. And the most important thing, you have to attach the file that you want to give to the students. So I'm going to click on attach sign at the top right side, the first option, and at the top right side you will click on this sign, and you can see there are some options: drive, link, upload file, take photo. You can upload the file by taking the photo, okay, as well. But if you want to upload the file from your mobile phone or your device, you will click on upload file. Okay, and then you will choose the folder in which you have your file, and then you can upload the file. First, suppose I'm going to choose the file from my folder. I have already saved some files here in this folder. First, suppose this is the, you can see the file that I have want to upload. You can upload text files, word files, images, and the PDF files in the Google Classroom. Okay, it's optional to you that which file you are going to upload. And after clicking on that, you can see after some time the file have been uploaded in the class. And if you want to schedule it, you can schedule it. Let me show you how to schedule the file. You can click on the schedule. Okay, and you can see in the at the top the black bar, okay, the bar which have the black color, there are the options: schedule for July 30. Okay, you have to schedule the file. If you want to schedule, you have to schedule it 1 day before. Okay, at least 1 day before, at least. Maximum you can upload the 30 day for, 1 month before, you can upload 2 months before. Okay, it's up to you. But at least 1 day before you can schedule the file. And after that you will give the time for which that assignment will be shown to the students. For suppose I'm giving the time 10 o'clock 10 o'clock and after that you can see that file will be uploaded in the student's account at 10 a.m. and after you can click on OK. You can see there is written schedule for July 30, 10 a.m. and the due date is also July 30, 12 p.m. Okay. It means the assignment will be shown to students at exact 10 a.m. and the students can upload the assignment till 12 p.m. Okay. And after that, you will click on schedule. Okay. You can see the assignment has been scheduled. And the first assignment scheduled for tomorrow. Okay, the assignment is scheduled for tomorrow. It means tomorrow the assignment will be shown to the students at 10 p.m. and students can upload the assignment in Google Classroom till 10 a.m. the assignment will be shown to students and students can upload the assignment till 12 p.m. Okay, let me show you the how to assign the work assignment. And then title, first part title is simple title and description. You can write and description and then points. You can type due date. If you want to give due date, you can. These options are optional to you. Okay. If you don't want to give due date, it's also the possibility. Okay. And first part I don't want to give the. So okay, let me give the due date. This is the due date and time. You can see 1 p.m. okay, till 1 p.m. and after that, if you want to upload the work in the student's account right away, you will click on the arrow sign at the top right corner, the second option, the arrow. You will click on that. Okay, you can see first the assignment that I have assigned to the students is the blue colored and the assignment which I have scheduled is the fade color. Okay, the color will be changed at the time when the assignment will be uploaded in the students accounts. So you can do these two things with the uploading and scheduling the assignment. And let me show you the how to upload the material. You can see data bank files, PDF files, or the helping material for the students. You can upload in the material tab, the third option, material, and title of the material. First, suppose I want to give the title, data bank chapter 1. Okay, and then description. You can type any description, any message for the students, and topic. If you want to give the if you want to make the folder, you can choose the topic, first post topic, add topic. You can see data bank. Okay, then save. After that, you will upload the file, and then you will search for the file, first post chapter number 3 and new doc. You can upload any number of files. Okay, and then click on open. If you want to attach more than one file, you will again click on attach option and upload file, and then same procedure, the file will be attached. Okay, and if so on, you can upload any number of files in your material and in your assignment. Okay, both. Okay, after that you click on the arrow sign. Now you can see the data bank folder have been created, and this folder can contain only one file, data bank chapter 1. Okay, and if you want to upload chapter 2 later on, you will click on material, click on chapter 2, okay, type chapter 2, and description optional, no description, and topic. If you want to upload the chapter 2 in the same folder, you will click on data bank again and save, and then you will attach the file by using the same process, and then passport. This is the file that I want to upload in chapter 2 folder. Okay, uploading a file takes some time depending on the speed of internet. The file has been uploaded. You click on the arrow sign at the top side. Okay, you can see data bank folder have two files, chapter 2 and data bank chapter 1. You can upload any number of files in the folder, okay, data bank folder. So that's all for this video. If you have any queries, you can ask me in the comment section as well. And I will also give the link of previous video in the video description. So you can also check the previous video that how to make and join Google Classroom and create classes. Okay, you can create any number of classes, and the classes will be created according to your timetable. Okay, the timetable which have been given to you and the classes which you are teaching, classes will be created according to that. Suppose you are teaching six classes, six sections. You are going to create six classes in the Google Classroom. Okay, that's all. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.